Genshin Impact is a wondrous game, with an ever-growing world and stylish art design, it's able to easily capture the imagination of players. Whether you enjoy the world, story, gameplay, one aspect that will keep players coming back is the amazing characters in Genshin Impact. So, I'm Darkblade, with a character guide to the Anemo Traveler in Genshin Impact. In this guide, we will briefly go over the basic lore of the character, their moves, abilities, weapon options, stat priority, and artifact suggestions. Remember though that these guides are aimed at free-to-play and beginner players, so these guides will feature characters as if they were Constellation level 0 with 4-star weaponry. There may be one or two exceptions to this, but for the most part, we are going to be focusing on the easier to obtain aspects of the game. The Traveler in Genshin Impact, sometimes known as the main character or MC, also sometimes known as Aether or Aether if you're playing as the male protagonist, or Lumine if you're playing as the female protagonist, everyone should have access to them. Whether you pick Aether or Lumine, both the twins play a role in Genshin's overall story, with the one that you didn't pick being a motivation for the main character. Being not part of this world, the twins were traveling the universe until an unknown god blocked and captured one of them, sealing them away from their travels and leaving them stranded in Teyvat. Now they're on a mission to rescue their sibling as they journey with Paimon through the world of Genshin Impact. Of course, this is the backstory of the Traveler. There is going to be a lot more story as the game progresses and is expanded upon, but ultimately, they are the focal and central part of Genshin Impact's story. The Traveler also has the unique ability to resonate with the various elements found in Teyvat. Praying at one of the various statues of the Seven, you're able to change the elements of the character, which fundamentally changes how the Traveler plays. In this video, we'll be going to be looking at the Anemo Traveler. But with that, let's move on to the moves and abilities the Anemo Traveler has. Anyway, the first talent is the combat talent known as Normal Attacks or Foreign Iron Wind. This is a straightforward attack sequence, performing up to 5 rapid strikes. You can also hold down the attack button to consume a small amount of stamina to unleash a rapid strike with your sword that hits twice. This will also knock back opponents. On top of that, if you should press the attack button while in mid-air, you'll perform a straightforward plunging attack, dealing AoE damage when you hit the ground. Pretty straightforward in terms of the character's attack pattern. However, the next combat talent is Palm Vortex. When you press your elemental skill button, the main character will grasp the wind's might, and with that, from your palm you'll form a small vortex, which deals Anemo damage. Now you can actually hold down the elemental skill as well, which allows the ability to pretty much charge up, dealing constant damage for a short duration before exploding in a massive AoE. Now, as this deals Anemo damage, you have to be aware that this ability can absorb other elements. So if the vortex comes into contact with Hydro, Pyro, Cryo or Electro, it will deal additional damage of the element it absorbed. This, however, can only occur once per use of the Palm Vortex. And then finally for the combat skills is Gust Surge. This is your elemental burst. When activated, guiding the path of the wind's currents, you summon a tornado in front of you that moves slowly forward. This will pull objects and opponents into it, dealing Anemo damage. On top of that, much like Palm Vortex, if the tornado comes into contact with Hydro, Pyro, Cryo or Electro elements, it will deal additional damage of that elemental type. Once again, the elemental absorption can only occur once per use of Gust Surge. So there we have it, those are the combat talents that the Anemo Traveler has available to it. But there are a few passive ones. The first passive is Slitting Wind. Basically, this allows the last hit of your normal attack combo to unleash a Wind Blade, which is a horizontal Anemo arc in front of the Traveler. This deals 60% of your attack as Anemo damage to all opponents in its path. So it's a nice way to deal Anemo damage, cause the swirl elemental reaction without actually having to rely on the Palm Vortex or the Gust Surge. And the other passive is Second Wind. Whenever you perform the Palm Vortex, so your elemental skill, if you're able to kill an opponent with it, it will regenerate 2% of your overall health for 5 seconds. This effect can only occur once every 5 seconds as well. So a little bit of a survival skill there, but it's not a huge healing talent. Now before we go on to the next section, I just want to briefly cover and mention that the Anemo Traveler becomes more useful when it's able to get to Constellation 6. And as the main characters are easy to increase their Constellation level, I'm going to mention it here. Basically, Constellation level 6, known as Intertwined Winds, makes it that opponents that take damage from your Gust Surge, so your elemental burst, they will have their Anemo resistance decreased by 20%. On top of that, if an elemental absorption occurs when performing the elemental burst, so it touches Electro, Hydro, whatever, then enemies will also have their resistance towards that corresponding element decreased by another 20% as well. So even though Gust Surge cannot pick up heavy enemies, having this constellation can still allow the Animo Traveler to debuff opponents, making them take more damage. So let's move on to the next section where we talk about artifact builds and weaponry. Now there are two builds that I pretty much use for the Animo Traveler, although there are many builds out there. Both of them are pretty much sub DPS builds. One of them focused more on dealing damage, one of them more support. First of all, the all-round damage build. This build is good for if you're just starting the game, you don't have a main DPS necessarily in your team, or you haven't been able to pull one yet from the wishes, and is an okay all-round build. So first of all, when it comes to the weapons, I was using Sword of Dissension, but I know not everyone has access to it because it is the PlayStation exclusive sword, so you can replace it with anything that pretty much has a decent base attack with an attack percentage stat attached to it. With the flute would also be an example of an easy weapon to get a hold of, or if you're really on a budget, you could go for the 3-star fillet blade weapon as well. When it comes to the artifacts, I've gone for a 2-piece Gladiator's Finale and a 2-piece Viridescence Venrir. This will give us an attack increase of 18% as well as an animo damage increase bonus of 15%. On your sands, you want to go for attack percentage, animo damage on your goblet, and then crit rate or crit damage on your circlet. As for the substats, focus on attack percentage, crit rate, or crit damage. Now with this build, when it comes to the talent priority, as we are going for a main DPS one, we're going to have a little bit of a balanced talent priority here, specking a little bit into everything. Which brings us onto the second build, which is pretty much how I use the Animo Traveler now, and is probably the better of the two builds, but is more suited for when you have a replacement main DPS in your team. When you have that, then this build is probably what I would advise going for, which is the Viridescence support build. This is still a decent DPS build, but makes use of the Traveler's Gust Surge ability to debuff enemies, as well as the Viridescence set bonus, which will also aid to debuffing enemies, making them take more damage. So for this build, with the weapon, you're going to go with the Iron Sting. This is easily craftable and comes with a decent amount of elemental mastery, which will help when it comes to our swirl reactions. Alternative weapons could be the Festering Desire if you have it, or the Sacrificial Sword, which come with decent energy recharge as well as sub bonuses on them. As for the artifacts, as I said, we've gone for the 4-piece Viridescence set, which will leave you with a spare piece of your choice. As for the stat priorities for this build, you'd want to focus on energy recharge for your sands, so you can perform the Gust Surge more often, animo damage on your goblet, which will increase the damage of our Palm Vortex and the Gust Surge itself, and then finally crit rate or crit damage on your circlet. As for the substats, focus on energy recharge, attack percentage, crit rate, or crit damage. As for the talent priorities, you want to go for Gust Surge first, followed by Palm Vortex, and then finally, if you want, you can invest in your normal attack. So those are the builds I like to use for the Animo Traveler. But every character out there in Genshin Impact has pros and cons. When it comes to the Animo Traveler, its pros include that its elemental skill and burst offer the character crowd control options. Especially when it comes to smaller opponents, you're easily able to pick them up in the various vortexes that you can create, preventing them from attacking you and knocking them back. On top of that, there's the elemental absorption that your burst and skills have, allowing you to absorb the other elements in the game and applying them to your attacks. And then finally, when it comes to the pros, is that your normal attack can apply animo to opponents should you perform the full combo. But of course there are cons. There are two major ones for this character. First of all, when you perform your Palm Vortex, you're locked in place, especially if you're holding down the elemental skill and going for maximum damage. This can leave you at risk of taking unnecessary damage, but you can always just release it when desired if you know there's an incoming hit. And the other con is, unfortunately, your skills and burst have a slightly long cooldown. It's not the worst, but it's still going to be noted as a con. So there we have it, that is the Animo Traveler, and how I like to use him or her in Genshin Impact. Overall, the character is alright. It is perfectly fine and capable of doing content. It can perform multiple roles as well. It's a little bit of a jack of all trades. However, I find it much better as a debuffer and support DPS rather than a main DPS character. However, like I said, if you're picking up the game for the first time and you don't have a main DPS yet, then the Animo Traveler can kind of fill that role a little bit, but once you get someone better, turning him or her into a character that makes use of that Viridescence 4 set bonus and having that C6 Gust Surge turns him into a perfectly adequate debuffer for your team. When it comes to the team compositions with the Animo Traveler, they can pair pretty well with any other character in the game. Given their main character status, this is definitely welcome. If you're using them as a main DPS, coupling them with a Cryo and Electro character so you get the Super Conduit physical damage debuff can help when performing your normal attacks, but if not, if you're using them as more of a support DPS, mixing them with teams that rely on elements and elemental reactions is probably more beneficial. So there we have it, that's the character guide, an overview of the Anemo Traveler in Genshin Impact. Now remember that there are multiple ways to play characters in the game, which is one of the many aspects that makes Genshin Impact enjoyable. So at the end of the day, use the characters how you want to use them. These builds are how I like to use the characters, and I hope they will give you some ideas and help you out in your adventures. So until next time, I've been Darkblade, bringing you a character guide to the Anemo Traveler in Genshin Impact. Hope you enjoyed the video, thanks for watching, subscribe and like for more.